So a lot of times, if you're working with iPhone footage in Premiere Pro, you might notice that the footage that you shoot is in HDR and it looks overexposed in your timeline. In this short video, I'm gonna go over the ways that you can fix this inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we open Premiere Pro, I just want to mention that if you're not on the latest version, I recommend doing so. There's a few features that came out within the last few years that kind of remedied these situations with when it comes to HDR footage with iPhone footage specifically. So let's take a look at some of the settings that you can change inside Premiere Pro. So as you can see, we're inside Premiere Pro and I have a HDR iPhone video and I made a new sequence in the preset setting for social media portrait, so it's a vertical video. And under the color space, it's a Rec. 709 color space. And this is important to keep in mind because most color spaces when it comes to social media videos, web videos, TV, they're all in Rec. 709. And the iPhone records in HDR, which is 2100 HLG. So one of the first things that you can do and one of the new features that came out recently is that you can auto tone map the media. So to do that, you can go up to sequence settings, and check the box next to Auto Tone Map Media. And like we were talking about, the working color space is right here, and we wanna make sure we're in Rec. 709, not Rec. 2100 HLG. And then click OK. You might see this pop up, but if you click OK, you'll notice that the footage kinda corrects itself. It's not as overexposed as before when it looked more overexposed like that. One other way that you can adjust this as well is to interpret the color management or the color space differently for the video clip. So inside your project, what you can do is right click on your clip and go to modify color. Or if you don't see color, you can always click on interpret footage and go over to the color tab. You can change the color space from Rec. 2100 HLG and override it to be Rec. 2020 or Rec. 709. In this case, since it's iPhone footage, I'm gonna do Rec. 2020 and then click OK. You'll notice that it looks more natural in the end result here. So those are the two main ways, and if you still need to do some adjustments, you can always use the Lumetri color panel to make adjustments, but it gets it close enough to where you can then fine tune it inside Lumetri color. So those are my solutions when it comes to working with HDR video inside Premiere Pro. If you want to learn more about Lumetri color and how to color correct your footage, I recommend checking out this video right up there. But that does it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments section below, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.